This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to graph linear inequalities. So the first inequality is y is greater than or equal to 1/2 x minus 2. To start with, I'm going to treat this as if it's just an equation, y equals 1/2 x minus 2. And since this is in slope-intercept form, I can graph it fairly easily. I know the y-intercept, that's this minus 2, the negative 2 at the end of the equation. So I'm going to put a point at y equals negative 2. And I know the slope, that's the coefficient of the x, or 1/2. So from that point at y equals negative 2, I can go up 1 and over 2. I can go up 1 again and over 2. I'll put dots in each time I do that. And then I'll just connect those dots. And I've got a straight line, which is the graph of the equation y equals 1/2 x minus 2. But this is an inequality. With an inequality, you're going to shade the area either above that line or below that line. As a general rule, as long as you've got your y on the left side of the equation, or the inequality, if you've got a greater than sign, as we have here, you shade all the area above the line. If I had a less than sign, I would shade the area below the line, down here. Now, what that shaded area means is that if I pick any point in this entire shaded area and take the x-coordinates and the y-coordinates for that point and plug them into the inequality, what I'm going to get is a true statement. So let's try that with a point and make sure that it works. Let's take the point, 2, 2. So at that point, x equals 2 and y equals 2. I'll just take that, those values and plug them into the inequality. So instead of y, I want 2 is greater than or equal to 1/2. And then instead of x, I want a 2 minus 2. So that's going to become 2 is greater than or equal to 1/2 times 2 is 1 minus 2. And then we end up with 2 is greater than or equal to, negative 1, which is obviously true. If this is true, then we could pick any point in that shaded area, and it would satisfy this inequality. Now notice the inequality was, let me clean this up, was greater than or equal to. If we didn't have that or equal to part, instead of drawing a solid line, what I would do is have a dotted line. So we use a solid line when it's greater than or equal to, or less than or equal to. We use a dotted line if we don't have the or equal to part. Okay, I want to do another inequality. I want to do something that instead of being in slope-intercept form is in standard form. So let's do 3x plus 2y is less than 12. I'm going to start out by graphing this as if it's an equation, 3x plus 2y equals 12. Remember, when we have something in standard form, the x and the y are both on the same side of the equation, we can find the x and y intercepts fairly easily. Here's how we'll do this. Every point along the x-axis has a y value, which is 0. So if I'm looking for the x-intercept, I know that the y value is going to be 0. So I could just think of this equation as 3x would be plus 2 times 0, which is 0. So I'll just make it 3x equals 12. And then if I divide both sides of the equation by 3, I would get x equals 4. That means I'll have an intercept, an x-intercept at x equals 4. We'll do the same approach to find the y-intercept. on the y-axis, all of the x values are 0. So to find the y-intercept, I just want to take the 2y and say 2y equals 12, divide both sides by 2, and I would get y equals 6. So I have a y-intercept at y equals 6. Take a straight edge and connect those two points, the two intercepts. Now I've got a line for the equation. It was an inequality, so the first thing I'll do is make this into a dotted line, since it didn't say or equal to. And I've got 3x plus 2y and a less than sign. Once again, if the y is on the left side of the equation and you've got a less than sign, you're going to shade all the area below that line. If it was a greater than sign, I would shade the area above the line. And now, what this means is that if I pick any point in that shaded area, the coordinates for that point, the x and y coordinates, will satisfy this inequality. They'll make that inequality true. So let's pick a really easy point. Let's pick the origin. At the origin, the coordinates are 0 and 0. So x is 0. That means we've got 3 times 0 plus 2 times 0 is less than 12. That's just like saying 0 is less than 12, which is true, which means any point in this shaded area will make this inequality a true inequality. Okay? And that's it. Take care. I'll see you next time.